Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on applications of solving an equation, which essentially for us here, that's just going to mean that we're going to be given a situation where we have to write an equation that we're then going to have to solve. So let's read through what we have here to see what we are looking at for this problem. So it says that a roofer earns $24 an hour plus $36 an hour overtime. So if he puts in 40 hours of work in a specific week and he wishes to make $1,200, how many hours of overtime does he need to work? All right, so if he gets paid $24 an hour, and obviously he's going to be able to get paid overtime for this particular job as well, he is wanting to have at least a $1,200 paycheck. So he's trying to figure out, well, how many hours do I need to work to at least make that mark? So first off, let's see what we can write down and piece this together. So he earns $24 per hour, right? So that's $24 here times however many hours he works. Plus, he is going to make $36 for every overtime hour he's going to work. And he wants this to at least equal $1,200. It can equal $1,200 or it could be greater than $1,200, but we're reaching for that $1,200 mark. So $24 times however many hours he works at that rate, plus $36 times however many overtime hours he's going to work. Now, we're solving for overtime hours, so we're solving for this piece right over here, which means we're going to have to try and plug something in for this H by that 24. So this is going to give us $24 times his regular hours that he makes in a week, plus $36 times his overtime hours. So we do know that he's going to work at least 40 hours, and those 40 hours are at the regular pay rate. So he makes $24 an hour from those 40 hours of work. That's his full-time paycheck there. But he's going to be working some overtime, and that overtime that he works is going to be at that $36 an hour rate. So we would take $24 times a 40-hour work week plus 36 times however many overtime hours he's going to be working, and we want that to be that $1,200. So we're solving for this H here, this overtime hours, and we are going to simplify down this equation to see if we can solve for that amount of hours. So starting with the left-hand side over here where we have this multiplication going on, that is 24 times 40. So 24 times 40 is 960. So if he works a 40-hour work week, he makes $960. But he's wanted to work some overtime, make some extra money. So let's drop down the rest of the equation so that we can solve and see what he would be looking at here. So if we're solving this equation, then we're solving it for H. So we need to get rid of the 960. So I'm going to subtract 960 from both sides. And when we do that, we are left with 36H is equal to, well, let's see, 1,200 minus 960 leaves us with 240. And all we have to do is divide both sides by 36. All right, so if we would divide both sides by 36, we get approximately 6.7 hours. So he would have to work close to 7 hours of overtime in order for him to make that $1,200 paycheck. Otherwise, just whenever you're looking at problems like this, honestly, in my opinion, the most important part of it is setting up these equations here. Had we set up the wrong equation from the start, doesn't matter how perfect our work is after that, it would be incorrect because we weren't working the correct equation. So make sure that you do get some practice in on working with word problems, understand the meaning of words. There are different tables and charts that you can look up that have math language and kind of help you understand what some of these terms do mean. Or if you need something like that, just shoot me a message and I can send you the table that you would need in order to understand some of that. Otherwise, that is it for this video.